All right, y'all. We are going to start today in simple sitting posture. So finding yourself in your comfortable sitting pose, Sukhasana, cross-legged if you can, or any variation that you prefer. Your body weight coming back into your sit bones. And then your hands, again, wherever, always is comfortable to you, right? Something's just going to feel more natural to you, right? Open yourself to letting go of what you expect to feel. Your body will tell you if you listen. So today, palms up is what kind of feels right. Some days my palms down is what feels better, but today's up. And we're going to start a little bit differently today. We'll start the same, and then we're going to go to something a little bit different. So go ahead and close your eyes. So for this one moment, we are letting go of our sense of sight, and our attention gets to turn inward, and you get to focus to your breath. The intention to deepening the breath, lengthening the breath. Notice how you feel in this moment. What energy you've carried with you here onto your mat. And now let your eyes flutter open, keeping the gaze relatively kind of soft. Take a moment to look around you and just kind of take in your environment visually. And for this one moment, having no reaction to anything you see. No criticisms. Just notice. Now pick one object around you that you actually don't like that much. You're not in love with it. And just take a moment to look at that one object. And as you look at it, it's like kind of something you don't really love. You don't really like it that much. Just notice your reaction. Notice the emotion. Notice the thoughts, the words in your mind. Notice the tone in your own mind that happens with that. And now shift your attention to something around you in the space that you do love. It makes you happy to look at it. You really like this thing. And look at that object. And pay attention to the reaction you have, emotions, bodily reaction, breath, and of course the words in your mind, the tone of voice, if there is one. Realizing that power you have to simply shift your attention. Both of these things exist in the same space, but you can change where you give your focus. You can shift to things that are positive, and you can take in all of that good reaction, good sensation. And that power, that control is with you in a yoga practice. We hold poses. It is with you in life. As we inhale, reach the arms out and out. With the exhale, bring the arms out to the sides. Come halfway down. Just halfway. Squeeze your shoulder blades back into the spine. Feel that squeeze in the upper back. Stay here. I turn sideways so you can see the spinal movement a little bit easier. Stay here for inhale. You might even pull the arms back and kind of sway back a little bit, pop open your chest. And your exhale, take a little rounding and bring the arms forward like you're hugging a giant beach ball. Chin toward the chest. Inhale. Extend open. Exhale, contract, really round and pull your navel into your spine, tailbone tucks. Inhale, open, maybe look up. Exhale, squeeze a little bit deeper, squeeze your sit bone muscles, your pelvic floor. Inhale, open. This exhale, take it down. Forward stretch. Anything you need here. Walk it up. And changing the cross or the extension of your legs. Inhale, sweeping the arms up to the sky. Take a side bend over to the right. Inhale, lift to center. Exhale to your left. Inhale up. To the right, hold. You can stay here, or we can play a little bit. Take this top hand, try to wrap this hand around your right forearm or up at the tricep. I like the forearm. Grabbing your bottom arm, a pull with that front arm. And you can see how it kind of pulls the torso into a twist. Stretch down, keep the sit bones grounded. Instead of kissing you goodnight, I'm kissing strangers. Inhale all the way up to center. Always listen, but I never learn. To your left. Or you can stay here. We'll take that right hand around. Grab your low forearm if you can and pull your torso deeper. Big belly breath. Inhale, bring it up. Forward fold, exhale, stretch that one more time. Walk it up. Shifting, come into all fours. Arms under shoulders, knees under the hips, hips width apart. Cat cows, inhale, open belly, look up to sky, exhale to round. A couple more. Notice any stiffness you're holding in the back, neck, hips. Neutral spine and come up onto your knees. You can always take a blanket or a towel and cushion under the knees if you need to. We're going to take a little dip in the hips, hands on the hips, and dip back a little bit. Okay? So you're going to stick your butt out. Very similar to what you did when we're just sitting. So stick your butt out. Feel how that butt squeezes. And then tuck it in and bring it kind of like that cow or cat. But inhale, come all the way up, reach the arms, stretch tall. And exhale, take it back through, pulse it. So stick it out, tuck it in. Out, in. Three, two, one. Inhale, bring it up. Do it again. Exhale, back, tuck. And four, three, two, one. Inhale, lift. All fours. Return to cat-cow. And notice if there's any difference now in those cat-cows. Now that you brought some of that activation and that heat, and neutral spine, curl the toes, take your hips back and up on your downward facing dog, breathe. Explore your down dog. Should open the legs up wide. Roll the hips around. Twist. Your head can look under the arms. side to side to stretch the mat, the shoulders. Hug at the bottom of your mat. Breath is deep. Inhale, tilt your tailbone up high. As you exhale, return down to all fours. Scoot a little bit forward and take your right toes, step them back behind you. Take a moment to press through those back toes and stretch out that calf, the ankle. You can roll it if you want to. From here, slide the toes back. And bringing your left hip down onto that left heel kind of as much as you can, so it's not one-legged pigeon. Your bottom foot didn't move, it's still facing straight out behind you. Now as much as we can, keep your back toes curled and that back knee off the mat. If it needs to come down to rest, that's fine, but press it. Try to keep that leg activated, yeah? Drop down to your elbows if you can. Here's a little wiggle left and right. When you kind of wiggle your hips to the right, you'll kind of feel that stretch down into the right side of the body a little bit. Or maybe you don't, just depends if you're holding the tightness there. Shift some weight into this left arm and pick that right arm up to the sky. Breathe. Maybe gaze past the fingers. A little bit of balance work here. Keep that left hip down and bent, but that right foot still curled to be on the ground. Return the right elbow down. And switch it. Left arm up. Little twist. And try to keep that back knee off the floor. Can you settle more into that left knee, left hip? So you have one side of your body all bent and compressed, the other side's all open and reaching out. With your exhale, take it down. We're going to pop it up. So let that right leg pick up and lift. Yeah. Inhale, reach the leg up a little bit higher, spread your toes. As you exhale, curl in. You gotta get inhale, lift. Exhale, curl. Hold this curl. Now curl your back toes, left toes. This is gonna take you to three-legged dog. Inhale, extend up, and the right leg lifts to the sky. Whee! From there, take some circles in that right hip. Explore this three-legged dog. Right leg straightens, bends, crosses over, roll the ankle, the toes. Inhale, extend the leg up and high. With your exhale, take the right foot forward between your hands, finding your lunge. Knee over the ankle and take a dip. Inhale, ooh. In your dip, rock your body a little bit forward and backward, a little side to side or in circles. If you need less, drop the back knee, but if you can, try to keep it just hovering off the ground. Inhale, looking forward or up. And as you exhale, drop it down and come back to all fours. Okay. Feel that difference in the left and right side? Cat-cow. Recenter, front to the mat, other side, left toe step back, slide, or no, wait, hold it first, and then just shift a little bit. Getting ahead of myself. You roll the ankle if you need to. Now, slide the toes back, settle into that right foot, right knee, right hip. Feel that right side of your body is all bent, kind of compressed. The left side is all long, reaching open. And you come down to the elbows. Wiggle left and right. Notice that this side's different than the other side. Shift it over to that right arm, left arm, lift it up, but keep those back toes curled and the hip and the thigh facing down. settle into that right leg a little bit more. Breathe. Bring it down. Switch. Right arm. Back knee is still off the ground if you can. And bring it down. Pop it up. Leg reaches out behind you. Inhale. Exhale, curl it in. Inhale, open. Exhale, curl. Hold it. Curl the back toes and lift three-legged dog. And explore. Roll the hips around. Extend and bend the leg. Cross over. Twist. Whatever feels amazing. Inhale, straighten your leg up to the sky as much as you can. Your exhale, curl the knee through and touch your lunge. Inhale, dip your head over the heart and just explore a little bit here. I'm feeling most of this in my back leg. My right thigh. The right foot inside the hip a little bit. Every day is a little different. Every day our bodies are a little different. I think I slept weird last night. So your inhale, extend, open. Come back to all fours. Exhale. Curl the toes. Take it back down dog. Feet together as much as you can. Right leg. Inhale. Keep it up. Any amount. Exhale, step forward to lunge. We're in a high lunge. Inhale, reach those arms up to the sky. Really anchor your back toes. And real important is that squeeze of your sit bone muscles. You're going to feel it more in that left sit bone muscle. With your exhale, open twist to your right. Arms extend. You might dip those hips a little bit lower. You might look past your right fingers. Warrior two. Inhale. Windmill. Round your back foot. Arms open. That front knee hopefully did not wobble at all during that transition, right? As you exhale, hinge. Finding side angle. You can also drop an elbow onto the thigh if you need a little bit less. Pop arm can be high, it can be over the ear if you want that side body extension to go just a little bit deeper. Take this triangle. All you gotta do, straighten the front leg. That's it. Little to no weight in the bottom hand. You can always bring it onto a block or have it onto your leg or floor if needed. Pop arm high, over the ear. You can always wrap it if you want to. Stay here. This is your inhale. Can you open your heart up a little bit more? Look to the sky. Pyramid. Exhale. Fold into your front leg. Square off those hips a little bit. You might even walk your back foot forward. Just a little step. Half step or one step. I like to wiggle the hips. I'm a hip wiggler. I just like to wiggle the hips all the time. Feels good. If you want more in your pyramid, you have a couple options. One is you can pick up your front toes. You can bend your back knee, and it increases that stretch in the front leg. Another option is to lift the back heel, and that's going to shift your weight forward a little bit, and again, it'll increase the stretch in the front leg. So you can do both. Just feel that. Memory stronger than ten of me fears the enemy. The dark creeps like a shark in the cold sea. Where your hips are square here, as much as they can be, so you might want to walk that back foot up a step or two. Left hand plants into the ground or on the block. You can also bend the front knee if you need to get there. Right arm to the sky and find your revolved triangle. Breathe. Big twist. Squeeze your inner thighs. Really firm up the legs. your bottom hand it can come further away from your foot off the mat. It can come closer to the foot. It can go on the foot or even to the other side of your foot. Block helps a lot here as well. But one more inhale, roll the heart open to the sky a little bit more, squeeze those inner thighs. Pyramid. Exhale, fold it to your front leg. And inhale, just lengthen, bend the front knee slightly. Exhale, step forward and find your uttanasana, forward fold. It is your first time here. Hang out, enjoy it. Take all the variations you love. Breathe, check in. It's always very easy to sort of react to and pick out those things we don't like around us or inside us. And that's part of this practice, is being aware when that happens and being able to shift that attention. When I'm all alone with you, take in all the good stuff. Picking up pieces of my life, sometimes there's ones I just halfway, lengthen, press into the shins. Exhale, stretch a little bit deeper. Inhale, flat back. Bring up to the sky, arms lift, gaze up high. With your upside chair, hands to heart. Breathe. Stay here on my face toward you. So in your lovely little chair, we're going to take it into a one-legged chair. We're going to bring that right heel up. I'm going to mirror you. Right heel is up. And we're going to lift the right foot. We're holding. Bottom leg is bent. Need a break. Just stand up in time. Can you straighten the right leg out in front of us? Maybe. Breathe. Where is your mind focusing, right? And take this right ankle, place it up on top of the left side, try to open that right hip out into the side. Breathe here. If you want to go deeper, fold into the leg. So try to bring our hands onto the standing ankle and shin, not the floor. Unless you have to, or unless you're about to fall. Good. This is all also a balance pattern. Although it's harder to balance on soft ground. Hardness. So if you went low, you get the challenge of reversing. Return to chair. Chair. Stay there. Ooh, and stand it up. Oh, yeah. Inhale. Because it feels so good to your heart. And great. And put it out on the side. And put it up. Inhale. Exhale. Take your swan dive. Forward fold. Inhale. Lengthen. Exhale, plant the hands and come back into your very first plank pose. What? First time here? That's crazy. Hold it for a moment. If you want to, you can groove around a little bit. Have some boxes of music in the whole plank. Roll it forward into the tips of your toes. Exhale, find your chaturanga, right? Either one itty bitty little bend or that 90 degrees, but control your descent. Inhale, open up dog or cobra. And exhale, zip up your belly, take it back. Ooh, down dog, check in, breathe. Feet together. Left leg. Inhale up to sky. Exhale. Step it through for your lunge. High lunge. Inhale. Lift and hold. Pressing back through those back toes. Really trying to extend that back leg. A lot of times when I see this pose, I see people having a very lazy back leg. And if we can, really straight. Squeeze that sit bone muscle. With your exhale, open twist to your left. Imagine your left hand is going to touch your back wall. Maybe look past your left fingers. Maybe dip those hips just another millimeter. Warrior two, inhale, inhale up. That front knee wobble, hopefully not. As you exhale, hinge, elbow or hand, down to the leg, pop arm up or over the ear, side angle, hold for a moment, breathe. And all we do is straighten the front leg, let that bottom hand come down. Our top arm can stay up, overhead, wrapping around the low back, grabbing the leg if you want to. Triangle pose. Arms up your thighs, squeeze your sit bone muscles, pelvic floor. Your inhale, open heart a little bit more, gaze up high. Your exhale, fold it into the front leg. Again, square those hips. You might walk that back foot up a little bit to help that squaring. Stretch it out and breathe. Options, remember you can pick up the front toes, you can bend the back knee, you can just lift the back heel and shift forward. You can play with all the little variations. Wiggle hips. Grounding the right hand or fingertips or on a block and left arm lifts, finding your revolved triangle. Firm up your thighs, especially keep awareness of squeezing the inner thighs toward each other. Bottom hand can move further away from the foot, closer to the foot, on the foot. Whatever feels right. Listen to your breath. Feel the places in the body that are creating effort in this pose, and feel the places we can actually ease some of that effort. Sometimes we tighten things that really don't need to be tightened. We can soften in this activation. One more inhale, open heart, open gaze. Your exhale, fold it one more time. Inhale, halfway up, a little bend in the front knee. Push off and find your Uttanasana, forward fold. Hang out, breathe. Halfway at left. Exhale, go deeper. Inhale, flat back, reach up, gaze up high. Take it to your chair, exhale, bend your knees, hands to heart. We can always hold this position the whole time. We're going to pick up that left heel now. And extend the leg. We're going to bring the foot up first. Extend the leg if you can. Even the waist a little bit. Angle top of the thigh. Try to bring that left knee down and open as much as you can. Hold it here or fold. And finding maybe the standing ankle or shin, but trying to stay off the floor. Breathe. Relax your jaw. The lips stay closed if we can. And begin to return up to the hands. Return to your chair. Keep the knees bent. Oh, yeah. And let it come up. Inhale. Your heart. Oh, yeah. Inhale. Lift it up. Exhale. Take it all the way down. Forward fold. Inhale. Long. Exhale, plant your hands and bring it back to your second and last place. Hold it. Maybe groove. You want to get real groovy. Side to side. That can be as quick or as slow as you want. Center, heart forward. Inhale, tips of your toes. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, left arm for cobra. Exhale, zip up, take it back, downward facing dog. Tailbone is high. Inhale, child pose. Bring it down and breathe. Checking in. The hands come by your knees, press the body. Come down to your sit bone. You can find yourself in any sitting position that's comfortable to you. We're going to focus on the upper body just for a second. Opening the arms out wide. Take your eagle arm, just one arm under the other. Grab them. Or your other option is a bear hug if that's not happening. Either pose. Lift the elbows up and down. Roll the shoulders, roll the neck, roll the spine. Close your eyes to light. Just feel. Just breathe. Sitting tall. Notice which arm you have on top and which one's on bottom. And let's do the opposite. So inhale. Unravel. Other side. Exhale. And stretch it out. You want to change the pulse of your legs? You can. And release. Inhale, open it up. Take the hands behind you, interlace your fingers, palms face each other or touch. Just stay where you are and let those arms extend. Your chest pops, your head drops back. Explore here. So spread the heel forward. Roll the neck, round the shoulders, squeeze the shoulders, lean it back into the pose. You can go forward if you want to. And let it release. Shake it out if you need to. We're going to come down onto our backs. How are you doing? Doing great. All right, scoot up to the front of your mat and roll it back and up. Stay down onto your back. Take your knees into circles or you can hug them in. Just opening the low back, using the ground to massage your sit bone muscles around the tail of the hips. Bottoms of your feet touching the mat. Taking your left ankle, top of the right thigh, finding your one legged position here. So you can just stay here and rock it around. You can bring the legs closer in or add the arms if you wish. Looking for that perfect stretch. Sometimes an easy little refinement is to take your right hand on the right shin, hug it in. Left hand at the left inner thigh and push it out. Doing the both of those things at the same time really creates something magical. And if it hurts, of course, don't do it. If you start to go numb and tingly there, don't do it. And then take this top leg, cross it all the way over the bottom leg. Open the arms and take a twist over to the right. If cross legs is not happening, just uncross and stack knees, or you can find any variation of a twist that you love. Head goes the opposite way to the left. Good.
Keep my hands on my stretch. Take off just a moment, put them back up on the shelf. Kiss my little baby girl as a knee.
Return to the center, realign. Right ankle, top of the left thigh, the knee presses out and away, and explore your stretch here. Trying to find where you feel sensation. And find the top leg crossed all the way over the bottom leg. Open the arms, twist over to your left. Head turns to the right. Just close your eyes. Just to feel that good stretch. Any variations you need. Welcome to. I'm going to lead you through sitting up. So you can find yourself in any comfortable sitting position, any position with the legs that feels nice and good for you. The body weight coming back into the sit bones and again the hands in any position that feels comfortable. Shoulders rolling back and down, sitting tall. Close your eyes. Notice what you are perceiving with your eyes closed. Mm-hmm. what you can hear. What you can feel. And what you see. You try to let go of any images in the mind and just embrace darkness. And even with that darkness, you might notice little patterns of light and color and shape. They might move and fluctuate. And you observe that. And keeping your eyes closed, begin to move the head around in any direction that we're very slow. All you're noticing, as you move the face, the head, those patterns of light and color behind the eyelids change. You're just watching that shift. Sitting at center, breath fuller and deeper. Let your eyes flutter open, but keeping the gaze soft. Notice any colors or objects that immediately stand out to you. And inhale, reach the arms out and up. Exhale, hands to heart. All that power, all that positivity, this gratitude, this love we say to each other. Namaste.